this is Dennis again with the O, different perspectives of Oxnard, and I am very delighted right now to have the presence of State Senator Hanna-Beth Jackson with us. Today is the inauguration of the movie of Cesar Chavez. Can you tell me, have you been waiting for this movie? What do you expect is going to be, other than entertainment, is there going to be some effect from this movie on our community?
Well, I certainly hope so. Cesar Chavez was a great hero. He was a leader of extraordinary commitment and passion, and it's about time there's a movie about this great hero and leader, and I've heard wonderful things about the film, and it's something that should inspire particularly our youth, a source of pride for the whole community, and I think, as you say, wonderful entertainment, but a wonderful story that needs to be told about a man who really dedicated his life to making sure that others were given a fair chance, were treated with dignity and respect, and by focusing on the plight of the farm worker, I think he was able to accomplish a great deal, and yet there's still work to be done. So this should be an inspiration as well as a celebration.
Now, Senator Jackson, you have one of those rare opportunities in our community that you get the chance to actually argue issues to better our community and actually put your name with a vote. You've been working with the United Farm Workers for many years. I've seen you in the fields many times. What does the United Farm Workers movement and the history mean to you? And can you mention maybe some highlights that you've been involved with?
Well, of course, I was very proud to stand with the workers at the pigsweet factory many years ago when they were just simply arguing for a fair contract, being stonewalled by the company, and ultimately prevailed. But it's a battle that continues. It doesn't end. And so it's been an honor and a privilege to work with an organization that is committed to improving the working conditions, the wages, the lives of the people who it represents, and the farm workers are hardworking people. They deserve basic respect and dignity. Their children deserve the same, a good education, health care, and working conditions in the field which keep them as healthy as possible. I've been working closely with the UFW on issues relating to pesticides, relating to the ability to organize workers, and also, of course, the work that we've done very recently that will now require and allow those who work here in this country to have driver's license so they can drive safely to and from their jobs.
Now, many people, and I hear quite often, that this is history. This is something that happened in the 1950s and 1960s. There's still issues today, and there's still opposition today. How do you take this opposition that possibly these workers don't deserve the same respect that American-born workers would get?
Well, I suggest they just spend a day out in the fields doing that back-breaking work, and I think people will recognize how tough this work is, how hard these people work, how difficult the work is, the challenges to their health, the fact that, look, we're all people. We all have the same basic needs. We want to be able to raise our families. We want to give them the opportunities that exist in this great country. We want to make sure that people have a decent roof over their head, clothes, and decent food to eat. And these workers actually help provide that food for us. And I think that when we look at what these people are wanting, it's nothing more than any of the rest of us want. And I think everyone's entitled to that fair shake. And these farm workers are people who deserve that dignity and that opportunity. It's as simple as that.
And I know that you've done much for the community at large, but also for the field workers and their families, the future. Is there something that you believe that we can do in the near future or, you know, further off that you think that would change or better the lives for everybody that lives here, the field workers and also the people who enjoy the food that they pick?
Well, certainly increasing the minimum wage, making sure these people are paid a fair wage for their very hard work. And frankly, we need immigration reform. It's not a statewide issue, so all those of us in the state legislature can do is really encourage the Congress of the United States to do immigration reform. We've done what we can here in terms of providing as I mentioned, driver's licenses. We just need to start addressing the fact that immigration reform is a critical component. The backbone of our state's agricultural industry is these farm workers, and they really deserve to be considered and treated equally and fairly in the workplace, and that's what we need to strive for and achieve.
I would agree that many issues are actually on the federal level, but it's very important that we have the support from people such as yourselves, elected at the state level, giving that support. And my wish is that we would have a trickle-up effect. And I know, and I appreciate your work, and I thank you. I hope the community appreciates and thanks you for your years of dedication. Whether you were in office or not, I know that you've always been with our population in Oxnard and supporting the rights of our field workers. Any last words?
Well, I just want to thank your listeners and to thank you for bringing this program forward. I think it's important to remind people, instead of focusing on all the bad things that go on, is that we join together and we make good things happen if we work together, if we mobilize, if we organize, and if we make sure that our voices are heard. So I think that's the message, and that's the work I'll continue to try to do.
I thank you very much. This is Senator Hanna-Beth Jackson on The O.
An unprecedented strike in the Central Valley.
We believe the United Farm Workers and their leader, Cesar Chavez, represent the hope and aspirations of the vast majority of farm workers.
Every American has a stake to bring about social change within the system.
So who the hell is this Cesar Chavez?
Yeah, I heard he's Mexican. Seems a safe bet.
I'm angry that I live in a world where a man who picks your food can't feed his family.
We don't need you. We want you back to Mexico. Get the hell out of our country.
What do you think you're looking at, huh?
The citizens of Delano, they respect the law.
So do we. Especially the Bill of Rights.
Have you seen the headlines they're getting? That's costing us real money, Mr. Bogdanovich.
We don't have to negotiate. We have to dictate terms.
Last report estimates that we've cost them $17 million.
We can't hold on much longer. We gotta break this damn strike.
We have no laws to protect us here.
What if something happened to us?
With the boycott, there are no laws to stop us. What would happen to the kids?
This is about being a man.
What are you doing?
I'm standing up because somebody has to!
Mr. Chavez!
This is the moment, Cesar. This is what we came here to do.
You can't oppress someone who's not afraid anymore.